Netcasts you love.
From people you trust.
This is Twit.
Bandwidth for iFive for the iPhone is provided by CacheFly at CacheFly.com.
Hello and welcome to iFive for the iPhone, episode 76. It's a bicentennial show. Old people understand that joke, where we do laps in the App Store, and we crawl for tips and news and tricks and goodies, and we do it all without wearing our swim caps, because green hair is worth it. Number one. Well, it isn't Christmas, and it isn't my birthday, it isn't even really a special occasion, but I feel like it is because one of my very favorite internet services ever, Rap Genius, is now an iPhone app. If you're not familiar with Rap Genius, it's a community-driven database of hundreds, thousands, a lot, of rap songs that you might have always liked but perhaps not understood fully. Maybe there's some slang you don't get or hidden meaning or whatever. Now, if you hate rap music, that's okay too, because Rap Genius, the app, is much more than just rap. Started with hip-hop, but you also have Rock Genius, same idea, but obviously for a different genre of music, poetry, even news. For example, President Obama's 2014 State of the Union address is in there. You've got a few options if you're looking for lyrics. You either type in a song, or you type in a phrase from a song, or you can even use the app to identify a song that's already playing, like Shazam does. Then you get a ton of context from a verse or a bridge or a hook. Now, as a hip-hop fan, I absolutely love Rap Genius. In fact, I would like to marry it. But again, it's not just about rap anymore. This is just a good way to get a bunch of backstory or explanation on lots of different media. And it's totally free. Number two, the controversy about whether there's enough good and original content being written on the web is something that we're not going to try to solve in this single episode, but it is an issue. One that a new app called Inside is trying to solve. The idea behind Inside is it's a stream of the most important stories of the day that are summarized into nice short updates. These updates are human-powered, they're not algorithmic. And Inside's curators keep it really short, 300-character summaries. They're designed to be read nice and quick. Inside says it links only to the most relevant and original sources with the best reporting. So you can customize your update feed by voting on updates. It's kind of like the Pandora model for news, because the Pandora model pretty much works in any capacity these days. You swipe right in any update to read through the topic archive, or you check the top news feed for the 25 most important updates from the past 24 hours. Now, if you remember iFive covering an app called Circa a while back, in fact, we talked about it more than once, Inside reminds me a lot of that. They both summarize news in a human way, and they're designed to save you and me unnecessary time reading duplicate articles. But after using and comparing both, I think Inside really shines on design specifically. I like it a lot. And I think there's room for a little competition in the space of taking the fluff out of news and getting back to the facts. Inside is free. Number three, we got an email from Karen in Concord, California. Hey Karen, you're my neighbor, who's got a cosmetic duh tip that'll keep your friends guessing. She writes, I recently renamed all of my folders using emojis. I think as long as I pick ones that I and I alone can associate with the contents of my folders, it will help deter people from looking in folders if they don't know what's in them. If you don't care about looky-loos, it will at the very least be a topic of conversation the next time someone borrows your phone. For example, I use the emoji blah 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 for the folders with all my shopping apps. I don't know what that emoji is. I've tried to figure it out, Karen, and I just don't know what it is, but I guess that's the point, right? Yes, this is a fun tip. We haven't talked about it in forever. We have talked about it, but not in a really long time. I've never actually thought of using emojis, though, to throw off people. Maybe you have really nosy friends, and in that case, this is a good idea. But yeah, the point is, you can use whatever keyboard you have installed to name your folders. If you have the emoji keyboard installed, you can call it whatever you want, so go nuts, it's your life. Number four, Mark in Hastings, England wrote in with a photo app suggestion, and we're going to take it. It's called Kit Camera. It's the successor to the app Kit Cam, if you're familiar with that. And Mark says it's packed with features, it's really easy to use, and it's nice looking. Sounds good to me. Let's go ahead and check it out. So if you're taking a photo, you can view effects while shooting rather than after the fact, and that's nice. Not all apps do that. You've got 16 lenses. They add effects like vignette, tilt shift, fisheye, even kaleidoscope. Now, I haven't seen that one before. Plus 51 film types, add a ton of vintage and black and white effects, real-time white balancing as well. Kit Camera also supports full HD video recording, as long as you have an iPhone 5 or later. And there's auto image stabilization built in. Now, the app claims that photos taken in the dark are 4 times brighter. I don't know if that's scientific, but again, if you're using an iPhone 5 or later and you're shooting dark photos, that's always a good thing. You even got some artsy bells and whistles like multi-exposure, multi-shot, even time-lapse effects. In fact, I'll go ahead and say that Kit Camera has more creative controls than any other photo app that I have tried, and I've kind of tried them all. That said, in general, I think photo apps are all pretty good. They all have their special thing. Snapseed is the best for selectively adjusting just part of your photo, for example. I use that feature all the time. Kit Camera is likely a lot more than most of you are going to need in an app, but it is nice. And if you don't have a go-to photo app yet, give it a whirl. Finally, number 5. By now, you would think we'd all had enough weather apps in our life to last a lifetime, right? My current favorite is Yahoo Weather, surprisingly beautiful app from the media giant or whatever Yahoo's calling itself these days, until a few days ago when Dark Sky released its latest version of the best weather app yet, and it's so good that I can't help but talk about it because you need to know. So you launch Dark Sky, and right away you get an overview of whether or not you're safe to go outside and walk your dog or do errands before it rains or snows or some horrible thing that happens in states besides California. Using GPS, Dark Sky creates forecasts for your exact location. It offers minute-to-minute predictions for the next hour, detailed forecasts for the next day or the next week. You can even set push notification alerts for precipitation. So if you're like, let me know when it's about to torrentially downpour, or maybe just anything that might require me bringing an umbrella when I leave the house. Dark Sky's radar animation is pretty addictive. For example, it hasn't rained on the West Coast in like 4 million years, but I can see a storm front coming in, and I'll probably be driving in it tomorrow, so I'm going to skip my car wash today. Dark Sky currently supports the United States, the UK, Ireland, and some surrounding areas, so it's not the whole world yet, but it's a big part of it. It's $4, though. That's the most expensive app I've ever recommended on iFive that just talks about weather, but I promise you, this is a home screen no-brainer. One more thing, we got an email from Ryan, who has a little tip for VLC, which showed off last week after it got a big update. Ryan writes, you mentioned VLC will play a lot of weird formats. This is true in general. However, VLC for iOS won't play AC3 audio and can be finicky with other audio formats like AAC. I know this because almost all of my videos have AC3 pass-through encodes done in Handbrake. But fret not, there is a completely non-obvious fix for this. Close out VLC completely, then go into settings and change the time zone to a Canadian one, such as Vancouver. Then reopen VLC and your video, and you'll have sound. Wow, Ryan, you are an international man of magic. Thank you. It's actually not an issue that I've ever had, but I bet you just made a few folks' day. You're the best. All right, if you ever see or hear of a great app or trick on iFive and you'd like to go back over it again or pass it along to someone who cares, just hop on over to our show notes at twit.tv/iFive. Our links are there. That's where you can subscribe to the show with the feed of your choice or add it to your favorite podcast app. Email us with your app tips and suggestions and feedback, i5@twit.tv. Leave us a voicemail at 614 on i5 or send us a video with an app review of your own. I'm Sarah Lane, this is i5 for the iPhone, and we'll see you next week. Bring your umbrella, unless you live in California, except tomorrow.